In this video, we're going to be talking about fuzz pedals and buffers. I see the question come up often where people want to know what order is best to put them in, so I wanted to make this video so that you can be confident in the way that you set up your own pedal board. We're starting right now. My name's Jason Johnson, and I run a pedal company called Fuzzlord Effects, and on this channel, we do gear demos and tech talks made specifically for folks interested in doom metal and stoner rock music. So if you like that kind of thing, be sure you subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell. That way you don't miss any of the weekly videos we put out. If you'd like to keep up with what's going on at the Fuzzlord shop daily, head on over to the Instagram page at Fuzzlord Effects, and to see what pedals are available at any given time, head on over to the fuzzlordeffects.com website. So today we're going to talk about why buffers can cause issues with some fuzz pedals, the order that most people like buffers and fuzz pedals, and then we're going to wrap up the video with a sound demonstration showing off the things that we talked about. So let's get started by talking about why buffers can cause issues on some fuzz pedals. So the reason buffers can cause issues with some fuzz pedals is one of the things that they do is that they can take a high impedance signal like that of a guitar and transfer it over to a low impedance signal. One of the things that a buffer is really good for is that when we have long lines of cable and a lot of patch cables, we can lose a lot of high end out of our tone. So a buffer can really help alleviate this problem. So that's one of the good things a buffer can do, and one of the reasons we often have them on our board. But some pedals, like the Fuzz Face or Dallas Rangemaster, really want to see a high impedance signal on the input. So basically, they want to see our guitar. So what happens is when we put a buffer in between our guitar and one of those pedals, it can really change the way that we expect our pedals to behave. Usually on Fuzz Faces and Rangemasters, for example, we can roll our guitar's volume back to control the overall gain. So what happens is when we put a buffer in between our guitar and one of these pedals, we can cause some issues with that. So you're probably wondering right now if you have buffers on your pedal board. Most people don't go out and buy a specific buffer pedal, but most people have several buffers on their pedal board that they aren't even aware about. For example, all Boss pedals are buffered bypass. So like your TU3 tuner has a buffer in it, even when it's off. I'm curious to know right now, leave me a comment below, how many buffers do you think are on your pedal board? So that leads us to our next point, which is what order most people like buffers and fuzz pedals. A general rule to keep in mind is that fuzz pedals are best right up front in your signal chain. So guitar, right into that Rangemaster, or Fuzz Face, or similar, and then any buffered pedals afterwards. So for example, on my pedal board, I'll run Fuzz Faces or Rangemaster style pedals first, and then any of my other distortion or fuzz boxes, and then buffers afterwards. So like my Boss TU3 tuner pedal will go after my Fuzz Face. Some pedals, like the Big Muff, for example, don't really mind what the order is. So I encourage you on your setup at home to try both orders and move your pedals around and not just take this video as the only way things can be. But most people enjoy their fuzz pedals up front, any buffered pedals downstream on the pedal board. That way we get the tone that we're used to, our pedals react the way that we expect them to, and we can get that cool trick where we can roll our volume knob back and reduce the overall fuzz of the pedal. So I think we have a little bit better of an idea now of how to use fuzz pedals and where to put our buffered pedals on our pedal boards. So let's do a sound demo so we can actually hear what we've been talking about. And we're gonna swap up the order on a buffer and a fuzz pedal because I want you to know what to expect when you're setting up your pedal board. So thank you for watching the video. Hopefully you learned something from it. And again, I hope that you're confident now in the way that you want to set up your pedal board at home. I really encourage you to mix up the order and not just go by what other people tell you on forums or in this video, because there's a lot of different sound possibilities available. So before we get to the question of the week, be sure you like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any of the weekly upcoming videos. But here's what I want to know today. What's your favorite fuzz pedal on your pedal board? And also, how many buffers do you think are on your pedal board right now? I'm curious to see the number below and see who has the most buffers on their pedal board. Again, thanks for watching. I'm Jason Johnson with Fuzzlord Effects, and I will see you in the next video.